Hello everyone, welcome back to Mad About Cards and Crafts. Today I am sharing a watercolored textured background using the Unforgettable stamp set from Penny Black, my Daniel Smith watercolors, some B100% cotton paper, and I will put this down in my Misti and use some, I believe it's 1.5 inch or maybe 2 inch purple tape, and I am going to mask off an area because I do not want that entire stamp on my panel. I just want to stamp a section of it. So I will put that down. I'll take my foam pad out because you don't need that in there when you're stamping with a cling stamp, and I will use my Versamark ink. Then I will remove the tape. I did use my anti-static tool, but I did get a few strays. I'm heat embossing with this Wow Fine Gold embossing powder, and all of the products that I'm using will be listed in the description box below. And I do use affiliate links, which helps me out on my crafty adventure. It does help to defray some of the costs involved with creating videos. So if you can shop with those links, that would be greatly appreciated. I did heat up my Wagner heat tool for about 30 seconds before I took it to the paper, and now we're ready to watercolor. I used my distressed sprayer, and I did spray all of my colors because I really wasn't sure what colors I was going to be using. I do end up using more of a fall color scheme. So I start with this, I believe that I used the Myan Orange. And so I'm going to just, I was pretty heavy-handed with the water on that first flower, and I am using a high concentration of watercolor. So when I wet my brush and I wet my paper, I'm going direct to my pan. Usually I'll mix my watercolors on that white section of my pan, and I'll mix it with water, and that will lighten up the color. I'm going for a really deep color on this one, so high saturation of color. And by bringing my brush directly to the pan, I'm picking up much more pigment with that. So when you're looking at like a Debbie Hughes watercolor card, she is using a very light concentration and lots of layers. That's not the purpose. I wanted something that any beginner watercolor person could accomplish, and this is something that they could easily do. By heat embossing, you are creating little wells for that paint to stay in, so you don't get the muddying that you might get if you were trying to do a no line or just a single layer image without any heat embossing. So I did use some brown oxide transparent on that leaf because I'm trying to use more earth tones, and it got too high of a concentration. Most of the time you could lighten that up really easily, but because it's such a small area, I really have to come back and work at it, and I don't get it quite as light as I would have liked to, but that's okay. Lesson learned, you know, be a little bit not as heavy-handed with those small areas. I do have the image sitting next to me, so I'm able to see where those edges, what they are, and color them appropriately. I do make one mistake, and I'll talk about that in a minute, but I want to get back to that rose right there. I laid down a lunar blue, or indigo blue, I'm sorry, which is kind of like a gray blue, and then I come back in with a cobalt blue, and you see how bright that is? That will dry back, and it will fit very well with the look that I'm going for. So I tried to add a little bit of green to that brown, and it wasn't working, so I thought, you know what, I'm just going to mute some of these other colors. And so I took that same transparent brown, and I just laid it down onto those leaves and to these flowers, and that will mute some of it. It looks really stark right now, but I promise you that it will dry back, and you'll see with the end results that it is not as dirty as it appears. Now this is the one that is supposed to be a flower, and for some reason my mind was saying leaves, so I came in and I colored them green and I just went with it. I just left it and didn't worry about it, and I think that it came out just fine. I will use a sap green on that, the center of that red flower, and it's just going to be, I'll mix it and it'll be just a little bit too bright. It almost looks chartreuse and I'm not happy with it, so I will come back and mute that down as well. So if you are not subscribed to my channel, I would absolutely love for you to subscribe. If you hit the like button, then it helps with the YouTube algorithms and helps get my video out into YouTube land and allow me to have more people view it. So I really appreciate your help in those areas. And if you have a comment, one of my favorite parts about being a YouTube content provider is being able to interact with you. So I would love for you to leave a comment and let me know, do you like watercoloring? Do you have watercolors? Does this look like something that you would be able to do? Leave that in the comment box below. I would love to hear from you. So I'm just going to lay down some Sleeping Beauty turquoise in that background, and I did it very lightly, as you can see, because I'm not sure how deep I'm going to get my colors, and I end up going really deep on the background. I did heat or let that dry. I'm sorry, I didn't heat it because of the embossing powder, but I did let that dry. You do not want to lay tape over your panel if your panel is not dry, because you will ruin it. So that is completely dry and it's a very low tack tape. I'm going to come back in with that Sleeping Beauty turquoise and that number 4 brush. I'm going to lay down some water, some very dirty water that you'll see magically gets cleaned. And I'm going to do some stippling. So back in the 80s, people used, or maybe it's the 90s, people used to lay down color and then they would come back in with a rag and they would add texture to that paint. And that was just a big deal back in the day. And I was looking for that textured feel. Now there's two ways to achieve it. The way that I'm doing right now, so I laid down the Sleeping Beauty and now I'm coming back in with let me see here. I believe that I'm coming in with the cobalt blue and I'm going to get kind of a teal color. And I did a stippling motion. Now I did switch my brush out to the number 8 because I wanted something a little bit bigger. But all I did was pounce on that. I was doing just a little bit of pouncing with the tape or with the paintbrush, and look at the texture that I got. So I'm coming in with my Ranger heat tool, which evenly distributes the heat, and I'm drying that panel off. I will try to get up close to the line where that tape is so that I don't have a stark white border, and I'm just trying to get it nice and even under there. And then I'm going to come in with the Heidi Swapp, it's a Chevron embossing, or not embossing, but stencil. And I will lay that down, keeping that floral area covered, and I'll bring in some Imagine Crafts spray in frost. And this is going to give me even more texture. Watch how this changes when I lift this up. It will give me just the most beautiful texture, and you can only see that chevron pattern. See, it looks like it doesn't, you really can't tell that that's a chevron pattern until you get it in certain light. See, right there in that light, you can see it a little bit better. When I reveal the pattern, you can see that the Sleeping Beauty is super light. So I'm going to come back in with a higher concentration of color. And this brush, again, holds. The silver brushes, they hold so much water and paint. It's just incredible. And so I decided that I wanted to go just a little bit darker than my background, and I am just doing, again, this really loose watercoloring. I am not trying to get a professional look. I want this to be very organic, and that was the look that I was looking for. So, anyway, that imagine crafts frost spray is probably one of my favorite sprays, and I know that it is on sale right now over at Kelly's Seven Kids Craft Store. So if you're interested in that or any of the other products, like I said, they will be listed in the description box below. And I am going to finish this up and decide that I want to come in with some gold foil paper. I think that's what it's called. What do you call this? Metallic paper? It's gold metallic paper. And I'm going to cut probably about, maybe it's like an eighth or a quarter inch strip, an eighth inch strip. And I am going to run it across the top and bottom. And look at how it just changes that look. So I will come in with some glue, some wet glue, art glitter glue to be exact, and I am going to glue those pieces down, and then I'm going to trim them off. I will lay the on the back, which I believe I'm doing right now. This is some tape, some double-sided tape that I'm trying to get rid of, and so I thought that I would just lay that down. And once I get it down, I burnish it into the panel with my embossing folder tool, or not my embossing folder tool, my, oh my goodness, what do you call it? When you, what is that tool called? Oh my goodness, it's the one that scores, the scoring tool, goodness. With the scoring tool, and I will burnish that into the background. I take the tape off and I put this on a Neenah 110 pound top folding 4.25 by 5.5 inch panel. And I look at it and I decide that it's still missing something. So I come back in with another 8 inch piece on the top and the bottom, and I like that much better. I think it just breaks everything up. It adds more interest to the card, and I will trim that off. So what do you think? Do you think that I should have left those gold pieces off, or do you think that that added to the design? Let me know in the description box below. So this is a sentiment from another Penny Black stamp that I have. It says, life is beautiful. I am heat embossing it in the same gold embossing powder. And then that is going to pretty much finish up my card. I'm going to come in with some Gansai Tambi gold splatters. I will put it in my splatter box, and I just want really the flowers to be splattered, so I'll use some makeshift items to block off the splattering, and that will be my card for today. Thank you so much for stopping by. I really appreciate all of you who support me and comment and follow me on other social media. I can be found on Instagram. And I just recently posted to my blog, so I'll start posting there. Here's a final look at my card. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll catch you next time. Have a great day. Bye-bye.